So after a minor injury and a great experience with Nicaragua's healthcare system, where I got stitches completely for free, which would have cost me hundreds of dollars in the United States, I'm back in El Carmen. A year after interviewing President Daniel Ortega, I sat down with my colleague Ben Norton to meet with President Ortega and his wife, Rosario Murillo, who is the vice president, for a private meeting with other foreign journalists. We had a wide-ranging discussion about everything from the reconciliation process since last year's coup to President Ortega's opinion of Bernie Sanders, to the migration crisis, to the geopolitical situation where Nicaragua is forced to confront being labeled part of the Troika of Tyranny by John Bolton. Our conversation lasted well over an hour, and we're going to show you all of it here. You know, a lot has happened since we last met.
Mucho ha pasado desde que la última vez que nos vimos.
I fell on my face and cut my head.
Me caí, me lastimé la cabeza.
The country has returned to peace and stability.
El país ha retornado a la paz y a la estabilidad.
The Frente is very strong. But Congress voted unanimously for the NECA Act.
El Frente Sandinista sigue muy fuerte, pero el Congreso de los Estados Unidos votó de manera unilateral por la sanción.
John Bolton has labeled Nicaragua part of the Troika of Tyranny.
John Bolton ha calificado a Nicaragua como parte de la Troika de la Tiranía.
And many progressive governments in Latin America have fallen away.
Y muchos gobiernos progresistas en Latinoamérica han perdido su rumbo.
You can see the situation of Venezuela, which suffered another blackout, maybe an attack yesterday.
Podemos ver la situación en Venezuela, que nuevamente sufrió otro ataque a su sistema eléctrico ayer.
Cuba is under blockade again, rationing food.
Cuba está bajo bloqueo económico con raciones de alimentos.
My question is about the way forward. How do you move forward in this situation with such an aggressive administration in Washington while still showing unity with Cuba and Venezuela?
Mi pregunta viene en ese marco. ¿Cómo puede seguir avanzando en el marco de un gobierno tan agresivo en Washington, agresivo hacia Cuba, hacia Venezuela y hacia Nicaragua? ¿Cómo seguimos de frente?
En primer lugar, fortaleciendo la unidad del pueblo nicaragüense.
First of all, by strengthening the unity of the Nicaraguan people.
Ya hemos vivido tiempos terribles, ¿no? De guerra.
We've already seen some terrible times of war.
Y bueno, ahora la guerra que está lanzando el gobierno norteamericano es una guerra que está disparando sobre el mundo.
And now the war, the attacks that the United States is launching is an attack on the world.
Lo que son agresiones de tipo económico, de tipo comercial.
Commercial and economic aggressions.
Que sacuden todo el esquema del comercio global, las finanzas globales.
That shake the entire financial and economic framework of the world.
Es un verdadero terrorismo.
It's true terrorism.
Yeah. Y bueno, aquí en América Latina pues tienen focalizado con sus propias palabras a Venezuela, Cuba y Nicaragua.
And here in Latin America they have pinpointed Nicaragua, Cuba, and Venezuela, in their own words.
Y ya conocemos las agresiones que han lanzado ya contra Venezuela, Cuba, ni se diga, son 60 años de bloqueo.
And we know the recent attacks that they've launched against Venezuela, and we don't even have to mention Cuba, it's over 60 years of blockade.
Y contra Nicaragua.
And now on Nicaragua.
O sea, Nicaragua está sufriendo lo que es el efecto de estas agresiones en el orden económico, en el orden comercial.
And here in Nicaragua, Nicaragua is suffering the effects of these aggressions, the attacks on our economy and our capacity to trade.
No nos referimos a lo que son agresiones personales.
We're not referring to individual aggressions, individual sanctions.
Sino a la que ellos imponen, afectando de operaciones financieras y operaciones comerciales.
We are referring to the type of aggressions that they impose that make it difficult for us to carry out our financial and commercial transactions.
Y con la NICAAT, ya sabemos, lo aprobó el Congreso, solo un congresista se opuso.
And in the case of the
antes, sí, en la primera fase.
And in the case of the NICA Act, we know that the Congress of the United States, previously, only one congressman opposed it.
Vicente González. Sí,
Congressman Vicente González.
Fue el único, la única voz.
Sí. The only one, the only voice that stood up against the NICA Act.
Y luego ya sabemos cómo se aprobó en el Senado.
After that, we already know how it was approved in the Senate.
Y desde ese momento ya la administración la está aplicando por la vía de hecho.
And from that moment, since that very moment it was approved, the government of the United States, the U.S. administration, is applying it in principle, carrying it out.
El representante del Tesoro en los organismos internacionales tiene una línea clara ya para obstaculizar, para bloquear.
The representative of the Department of the Treasury already has his instructions and he's carrying them out.
Pero yo diría que la agresividad de esta administración va más allá de estos tres países en América Latina y el Caribe.
I would say that the aggressiveness of this administration goes beyond these three countries in Latin America and the Caribbean.
Hemos visto de qué forma, de qué manera aborda el tema migratorio.
We have seen how the ways in which this administration addresses the issue of immigration.
Cómo insulta, cómo trata y maltrata a gobiernos que están muy de cerca.
How it offends and how it insults governments that work with them.
Cómo insulta a los pueblos.
And how they offend the people.
De criminales para arriba.
Calling them from criminals and beyond.
Al pueblo mexicano, al pueblo guatemalteco, al pueblo salvadoreño, al pueblo hondureño.
The Mexican people, the Salvadoran people, the Guatemalan people, the Honduran people.
Cómo les quita recursos que ya están asignados para ir a colocarlos contra Venezuela.
How they take away the resources that were assigned to these countries just to use them aggressively against Venezuela.
Yo pienso que esto está generando ahí internamente un sentimiento de rechazo.
I believe all of this is generating internally a sentiment of rejection.
Que no se manifiesta todavía a través de los gobiernos que más bien han sido movidos o desplazados a hacer un cuerpo a favor de esa política de terror.
This hasn't manifested itself within the governments of the region, because they still are operating as a group to carry out this policy of terrorism.
Y aquí lo que nos queda es, por un lado, la unidad de nuestros pueblos y la lucha que tenemos que librar.
And what we have to do is maintain the unity of our people and be clear about the struggle of the fight that we have to carry out.
En defensa de el derecho internacional.
We are fighting in defense of international law.
Porque aquí los disparos que parten del gobierno norteamericano van en todas las rutas, en todos los rumbos.
Because the attacks, the shots fired by the government of the United States are aimed at everyone, at everything.
Y toman decisiones que ellos llaman sanciones, sin que pase por un procedimiento que desde el punto de vista jurídico legal dé lugar a la aprobación de una sanción.
They make decisions, they carry out these policies without going through a juridic a legal process that can then approve these sanctions. Everything is done unilaterally.
Simplemente las lanzan, las aplican y eso genera una inestabilidad muy grande, ya incluso a nivel global.
They carry out these sanctions, they implement them, and they create great instability globally.
Así es que... el futuro es haciendo un frente común, una causa común.
The future is to making common cause, working together.
Los gobiernos que estamos siendo afectados, los países, los gobiernos, los pueblos que estamos siendo afectados.
The very governments, the very people that are being affected by these
unilateral sanctions. En el momento no alineado se tomó un acuerdo en la reunión que hubo en Caracas en este momento.
¿No significa trabajando más cerca con gobiernos como China y Rusia?
Sí, que acercándonos todos, los que estamos siendo afectados y agredidos, tal y como se acordó recientemente en la reunión de los países no alineados en Caracas.
We must all work together. All the countries that are being affected must work together, just as it was agreed upon in the meeting of the non-aligned movement in Caracas recently.
I wanted to ask about this. You were speaking about how the United States attacks
are global. Sanciones are global. Pues usted habla de los ataques y las sanciones del gobierno estadounidense y son ataques globales. But the resistance is also global. La resistencia también es global. So the non-aligned movement just met last week in Venezuela. El movimiento no alineado. Había una reunión del movimiento en la semana pasada en Venezuela. Do you think that Nicaragua and other countries in Latin America and other parts of the world can collaborate to circumvent and get around these unilateral U.S. attacks? ¿Usted cree que los países en América Latina y en otras partes del mundo pueden colaborarse y evitar los ataques y las sanciones y la guerra económica del gobierno estadounidense? And how do you think the world is changing? Do you think we're moving away from a unipolar world and moving toward a world where countries can actually exercise sovereignty without being afraid of being attacked by the U.S. and facing this phase of intense blockades? ¿Y usted cree que el mundo está cambiando desde un mundo unipolar a un mundo multipolar en lo que los países independientes pueden gobernarse y pueden evitar estos ataques y esta etapa, esta fase de asedio? Pues porque la estrategia del imperio hoy en día es el asedio. ¿Cree que este mundo está cambiando y en qué manera?
Yo diría que el cambio, la realidad, global.
I'd say that the change, the global change that needs to occur,
es que se estableció un mundo multipolar.
Is that a multipolar world is already established.
Y yo señalaría como un elemento muy significativo.
I would point out as a very significant element.
Hay que traer ahí
ese polo. Que se está viendo ya con más claridad, ya no con el sometimiento total en que se encontraba, como es la Unión Europea.
I would say that the rise of this pole that now is not completely subdued, in the case of the European Union.
Porque parecía casi una sola estructura, Estados Unidos, Unión Europea.
At the beginning, the European Union appeared appeared to be like a substructure of the United States.
Y bueno, la multipolaridad, bueno, en lo que era la emergencia de las fuerzas progresistas en América Latina, en lo que la unidad africana, en lo que los BRICS.
But the multipolarity began to rise, as is the case of the non-aligned movement, the case of the African countries, the case of the BRICS.
Pero en la medida en que el gobierno norteamericano no entiende que hay una nueva realidad multipolar, lo ha llevado incluso a fracturar esa unidad monolítica que tenía con la Unión Europea.
But in the measure that the United States is not able to comprehend that the world is multipolar, has even forced it to adopt positions that has broken this monolithic alliance that it had with the European Union.
Y claro, un actor determinante en toda esta batalla muy importante es el pueblo norteamericano.
But of course, a fundamental actor in all of this is the people of the United States.
Estamos seguros que no permanece pasivo frente a todos los atropellos que se están dando.
That we know will not remain passive in the face of all of this these attacks that are carried out by the administration of the United States, by the government of the United States.
Just I have a couple of questions.
Solo unas cuantas preguntas.
The U.S. involvement in Nicaragua, both in the 1980s and today, is very well known and well documented.
El intervencionismo de los Estados Unidos, tanto en los años 80 como ahorita, ha sido bastante bien documentado.
Perhaps less so and less known about is British involvement in Nicaragua during both of those periods.
Quizás se conozca menos, sin embargo, del intervencionismo de Inglaterra, tanto en los 80 como en este momento.
I'm just wondering two things, I guess, that a company called KMS, run by someone called David Walker.
Solo me preguntaban una empresa que es administrada por el señor David Walker, una empresa que se llama KMS.
And they worked with Oliver North and the Contras.
Que trabajaba con Oliver North y los Contras.
In March 1985, they were involved in the bombing of the Alejandro Davila Solanas Hospital in Managua.
Este grupo estuvo involucrado en el bombardeo del hospital Alejandro Dávila Bolaños en Managua en 1985.
I'm wondering if you remember the incident and how you would feel about those British mercenaries now.
Me preguntaba si acuerda de ese incidente en particular y cuáles son sus sentimientos sobre esos mercenarios ingleses de ese periodo, en ese periodo.
Esto me está refrescando, ¿no?
This is helping me to refresh my memory.
Aquí, la primera disputa que se da por Nicaragua.
Here, the first dispute that happens in Nicaragua.
Fue entre España e Inglaterra.
Was between Spain and England.
¿Qué es lo que se disputaba en Nicaragua?
What were they disputing?
Si no habían inmensas riquezas minerales.
Nicaragua didn't have enormous mineral resources.
No era de los países más ricos en oro que tanto andaban buscando en esa época.
We weren't among the countries that had more gold, which is what they were looking for in that period.
Habían descubierto los conquistadores españoles y los ingleses.
The Spanish colonizers and the English colonizers had discovered
que había un río que penetraba por el Atlántico hacia el Pacífico, hacia el lago, y luego un pequeño estrecho de 14 kilómetros que daba hacia el mar Pacífico.
They had discovered that there was a river that began in the Caribbean coast that went all the way up to the lake, and then there was only a small stretch of about 14 kilometers that took you to the Pacific Ocean.
Y ahí vino la primera gran confrontación.
And that's where the first confrontation happened.
Por dominar Nicaragua. Los ingleses apoderados de la zona del Caribe y los españoles apoderados de la zona del Pacífico.
The first confrontation which saw the British in control of the Caribbean coast and the Spanish in control of the Pacific coast.
Y en constantes choques militares.
And in constant military confrontations.
Los ingleses penetrando por el río a buscar cómo dominar y entrar al Pacífico.
The British going up the river to try to dominate the Pacific.
Y los españoles intentando pasar al Caribe y no podían pasar.
and the Spanish trying to conquer the Caribbean coast, but they couldn't pass, they couldn't advance.
La población indígena resistía el paso de los españoles hacia el Caribe.
And the indigenous population resisted the advances of the Spanish towards the Caribbean.
Entonces, luego entran en escena los Estados Unidos.
Afterwards, the United States comes to the scene.
Que cuando tuvimos a William Walker de presidente en Nicaragua.
When we saw William Walker as the president of Nicaragua.
Y luego Trump. Sí. y luego en el año 1895.
And then in the year 1895.
Mira aquí.
A message from the.
This is a message from Grover Cleveland.
Thanks. We have a message from the President of the United States. It's Grover Cleveland on February 7th, 1896.
Tenemos un mensaje del presidente de los Estados Unidos y está datado del 28 de enero de 1895.
To the House of Representatives, pursuant to the request made in a House resolution passed on the 30th day of January 1896.
A la Cámara de Representantes, en relación a los propósitos que tienen que ver con la factibilidad, permanencia y el costo de la construcción del canal interoceánico.
I'm going to paraphrase, but he's basically, I transmit the report for the purpose of ascertaining the feasibility, permanence, and cost of the construction and completion of the Nicaragua Canal by the route contemplated and provided for by an act passed by the Senate, entitled...
Se refiere al mensaje del presidente al Congreso en la relación al análisis de los estudios de factibilidad en relación a la construcción del canal interoceánico en Nicaragua, ¿verdad?
So the Canal Act, the first Canal Act presented in the
U.S. Congress. El primer acto del Congreso de los Estados Unidos en referencia a la construcción del canal interoceánico, 1895.
El Congreso está recibiendo ya el reporte de parte del presidente de los Estados Unidos.
This is the Congress already receiving the report by the President of the United States.
De los estudios que hicieron aquí en Nicaragua en esa época, la fuerzas ingenieras del ejército de los Estados Unidos.
Of the engineering forces brigade, the engineering corps of the Army of the United States. They were the ones who prepared the studies for the government.
And this was 2 years before the Spanish-American War. Dos años antes de la guerra entre Estados Unidos y España. Una guerra colonial.
Pero ya aquí tenemos que ellos andaban buscando el canal por Nicaragua o por Panamá.
With this study, you can see that they were already trying to see about the construction of the canal either through Nicaragua or through Panamá. And they're showing the map.
Estos son así como esto está toda la están todos los planos de todos los estudios completos.
Just like this, there are many other studies with all the maps and related to the construction of the canal. All of these studies were presented to the Congress of the United States. From that point, Nicaragua becomes a focus, a priority for the United States.
You were speaking about the importance of the American people, and there is there's been a movement outside of the political establishment to elect a socialist president in the United States.
Hablaba hace poco de la importancia del pueblo de los Estados Unidos, y actualmente hay un movimiento en los Estados Unidos para tratar de elegir a un presidente socialista.
This is someone who visited here in the 1980s.
Este es una persona que visitó Nicaragua en los años 80.
Bernie Sanders.
Me Senator Bernie Sanders. Bernie Sanders.
And he was videotaped actually talking about meeting with you, and he said, yeah.
Y fue fue entrevistado. Hay un video de él donde él afirma, ¿no?, su interés en reunirse con usted.
He said, I met with Daniel Ortega. He was very impressive. I was very impressed with the Sandinistas and the movement.
Él mencionó que en una reunión con usted, dice que se reunió y que estaba muy impresionado con usted, muy impresionado con el movimiento.
And this video has resurfaced to attack Bernie Sanders and to humiliate him by his opponents.
Este video ha resurgido en los Estados Unidos en el marco de la campaña y está siendo distribuido por sus enemigos, para sus oponentes, para tratar de ofenderlo, para tratar de humillarlo.
I guess my question is, do you see any hope in the movement behind Bernie and the possibility of a change in the United States' orientation towards your country and towards Latin America if he were to achieve higher office, if he were to get into the Oval Office, given the pressure that he's under in the United States, or would he...
La pregunta de él va alrededor de conocer su opinión. Si Bernie Sanders lograra alcanzar el poder, lograra llegar a la oficina oval, ¿usted cree que habría una posición diferente del gobierno de los Estados Unidos hacia Latinoamérica y el Caribe?
Or would you see him like another Hillary Clinton or Joseph Biden?
¿O lo vería como otra Hillary Clinton o Joseph Biden?
No hay imperios eternos.
Eternal empires do not exist.
Está más que demostrado.
It's more than demonstrated.
Los imperios más poderosos incluso se han extinguido.
The most powerful empires throughout history have gone extinct.
Tanto que quisieron dominar, tanto que quisieron abarcar, que luego...
They tried to dominate so much, they tried to control so much area that they just dissolved. They went extinct. They extinguished.
Y creo que Estados Unidos, con esa práctica imperialista que ha tenido,
I think that the United States, with this imperialist practice that it has tried to carry out,
está entrando a una fase terminal.
Has already begun its terminal phase.
Todo lo que está aconteciendo, todo lo que estamos viendo.
Everything that we are seeing, everything that's happening right now.
Que da la sensación, que da la impresión de que Estados Unidos es más poderoso que nunca en la historia de la humanidad.
That would want to present the perception that the United States is the most powerful, the strongest thing in throughout humanity.
No son más que golpes brutales disparados por todos lados que están provocando un debilitamiento en la credibilidad que tenían los Estados Unidos en sus mismos aliados en el mundo.
These last shots that they're firing, these brutal attacks, aggressive attacks throughout the world, are just elements that are delivering the final blow to the United States' credibility throughout the world.
Y esto abre las condiciones para que en Estados Unidos se produzca un cambio.
This is also creating an opportunity for change to happen in the United States.
Y que Estados Unidos, como potencia que es, sin dejar de serlo, acepte su papel de forma constructiva en el mundo multipolar que Estados Unidos debería contribuir a fortalecer.
It creates the opportunity for the United States to finally assume its role within the multipolar world, that the United States, with all its power, help to build the multipolar world that we need.
Y sobre todo, acompañar la lucha por la defensa del medio ambiente.
And more than anything else, to participate in the struggle for the environment.
Que entiendan que en el medio ambiente, si no lo defendemos todo, nos hundimos todos.
They have to understand that if all of us don't defend Mother Nature, that we don't defend the environment, all of us are going to sink, are going to fail.
Sorry, just as a kind of follow up to that question, really.
Una pregunta de seguimiento a esta pregunta.
Bernie Sanders.
¿Y si tiene alguna pregunta en particular sobre Bernie Sanders?
Sé que están manipulando eso.
I know that they're manipulating
esa visita de Sanders a Nicaragua.
I know that they're manipulating that short visit of Bernie Sanders to Nicaragua.
Es una guerra sucia.
It's a dirty war.
Y yo pienso que el pueblo norteamericano tiene la capacidad, tiene la inteligencia como para entender.
But I believe that the people of the United States have the capacity to see the difference, to understand.
Como el mensaje de Sanders, así como el mensaje de varias candidatas, precandidatas, mujeres, un mensaje muy valiente.
The important message of Bernie Sanders, just as the message of other candidates, other women candidates in the United States, messages of courage.
Todo eso va en la dirección correcta para que Estados Unidos se convierta realmente en un polo de paz, de desarrollo, de cooperación.
All these messages are very important because they create the opportunity for the United States to become a pole, a beacon for development and cooperation.
I guess as a kind of a follow-up, but with a British angle.
Una pregunta de seguimiento, pero con un ángulo inglés, británico.
So today we have a new Prime Minister, Boris Johnson.
El día de hoy tenemos un nuevo primer ministro, ¿no? Boris Johnson.
Who looks set to follow U.S. imperialism.
Que parece estar dispuesto a seguir el imperialismo estadounidense.
But like Bernie Sanders in the U.S., Britain has the leader of the opposition, Jeremy Corbyn.
Pero como Bernie Sanders en los Estados Unidos, en el caso de Inglaterra, tienen a un líder de la oposición, que es socialista, Jeremy Corbyn.
He's a long-standing friend of Nicaragua, but has also built a mass movement in Britain.
Que es un gran amigo de Nicaragua, pero que también ha creado un movimiento masivo en Inglaterra.
So how important is it for Nicaragua and for the region for Britain to follow an independent course and have an independent foreign policy apart from the U.S.?
¿Qué tan importante es para Nicaragua que Inglaterra busque su propio camino, un camino independiente de los Estados Unidos en lo relacionado a política exterior?
And what would you say to both Boris Johnson and Jeremy Corbyn?
¿Y cuál sería su mensaje para Boris Johnson y también para Jeremy Corbyn?
Contribuyan a fortalecer y a desarrollar un mundo multipolar.
That they must contribute to help develop a multipolar world.
Para salvar el planeta.
To save the planet.
Para la paz.
For peace.
Tengo una pregunta para la señora vicepresidenta. Pues, we've talked a lot about how the world is changing, but also Latin America is changing and the people are changing. Hablamos mucho de los cambios en el mundo, pero también hay muchos cambios en América Latina y en los pueblos de América Latina. Especially, there's a large growth in evangelical populations of evangelical Christians. En todos los países en América Latina hay muchos más evangélicos cristianos. In Brazil, they were a major force behind the election of Bolsonaro, the far-right president. En Brasil, los evangélicos apoyaron a Bolsonaro, el presidente ultraderechista. And at the 40th anniversary celebration, there was also an evangelical pastor who was very right-wing and who works in the United States who also spoke. And Drollinger. En el aniversario de la revolución, había un pastor muy derechista, estadounidense, evangélico, que habló, que dio un discurso. And then after him, there was a Catholic priest who spoke and called for peace and reconciliation. Y después del pastor evangélico, había un sacerdote católico que llamó por paz y reconciliación. So in the United States, the right-wing evangelical forces are associated more with Donald Trump and the right wing, and the people who would be sympathetic to the Sandinista movement here and support the struggle are very much opposed to those evangelical forces. En Estados Unidos, los evangélicos se asocian con la otra derecha, con Donald Trump, y la gente en Estados Unidos que apoya la lucha sandinista y el movimiento sandinista está muy en contra de este movimiento derechista evangélico. So what was the thinking behind inviting that pastor, and what was the thinking behind the invitation? Y entonces, ¿cuál fue el pensamiento de esta invitación? ¿Por qué fue invitado?
En primer lugar, el pueblo nicaragüense, un pueblo de fe, es un pueblo cristiano.
First of all,
todas las iglesias han tenido una participación a lo largo de nuestra historia de lucha en términos, sobre todo después de la guerra, de buscar la paz. Aquí se conformaron las comisiones de reconciliación después del 90 e incluso antes para propiciar, promover el encuentro en la familia y en la comunidad. Y participaron las iglesias evangélicas a través del doctor Gustavo Parajón y luego la Iglesia Católica a través del cardenal Miguel Obando y Bravo. Ya voy, por favor. Well, the Nicaraguan people is a people of faith. We are true believers. And throughout the years of the struggle, the different churches have played a role, especially in reconciliation and promotion of peace after the war and during the war in the 80s and in the 90s. So we cannot say this is new. And on the other hand, when we say we're a people of faith, some people are Catholic, some people are Christian, they say, they call themselves. During these hard times that we lived last year, we had a very important and sensitive contribution of different pastors in the municipios where the tranques were holding hostages our population, our people, and killing our people. And I would say that the promotion of reconciliation and peace from these commissions of peace that we created in the midst of the struggle for life that took place last year was very important. So we find that on one side, we all know what happened with the Catholic Church, and we are Catholics. We have been Catholics all our lives. I remember I used to insist during the 80s and the 90s to the Catholic bishops that we were Catholic and that all our children had been baptized. They wouldn't believe it. They wouldn't believe it. But it's true. And that contribution last year was so important to people in every small town of this country that I think it has played a role, that contribution, in some kind of growth of the feligreses, of the people who attend the religious services of the so-called Christian churches. So perhaps you didn't know, but over 30 pastors were taking part in the celebrations, Nicaraguan pastors, maybe more. And part of the meetings that we hold frequently with the different so-called Christian churches, part of those meetings made, I would say, possible the invitation to these pastors. We have had also pastors from different parts of the United States celebrating here. When I say celebrating, it's celebrating their services. They have come and they have taken part in religious meetings and encounters. They call them revival, avivamiento. They call it restoring reconciliation through family values in our country. And they come and they move freely through our country. And that is just part of the, I would say, the present or current situation in terms of the churches. It's nothing strange. It's something that has been happening throughout the years. And from last year onwards, I think it took a special, or it represented something very special, because people felt accompanied during those hard times.
Rollinger says that he's Trump's Bible teacher. He puts Bible study cards on Trump's desk in the White House.
Rollinger dice que él es su profesor de Biblia, que él pone notas sobre la Biblia en el escritorio del presidente Donald Trump.
This was not a message to Trump.
Este no fue un mensaje al presidente Trump.
Sobre el NICA Acto, algo así.
En referencia al NICA Acto.
Sí. Hace 15 días, 3 semanas.
15 years ago, or 15 days ago, or 3 weeks ago.
Salió un reporte del Departamento de Estado.
A report was published by the Department of State.
Acusando al gobierno de Nicaragua.
Accusing the government of Nicaragua.
De persecución religiosa.
Of a religious persecution.
Ustedes lo deben haber conocido ese reporte.
You guys probably have seen this report.
Y reportes donde nos acusan que aquí no hay libertad de expresión.
Reports in which they are accusing us that in Nicaragua there isn't freedom of the press, freedom of expression.
¿Qué? Libertad de expresión.
Freedom of expression.
Donde el pastor ahí podía haber dicho cualquier cosa. Nosotros no le pedimos el discurso que iba a pronunciar, no le dijimos simplemente diga lo que quiera.
We didn't give Pastor Drollinger a script. He was allowed to say anything he wanted to say.
Y creo que el hecho de que se ha dado esa presencia, ¿no? Del pastor y también de los sacerdotes católicos, mm-hmm, existiendo problemas muy serios, como ustedes saben.
The fact that Pastor Drollinger was present in that activity, along with the other 30 pastors, Catholic pastors among them, is very significant considering the events that are ongoing.
Da una señal clara de que aquí hay la más absoluta libertad religiosa. Y que hay la más absoluta libertad de expresión también.
It sends a clear message that in Nicaragua there is absolute freedom of religion and absolute freedom of expression, freedom of the press.
Yeah, I have a question. I guess it's kind of a simple question. It's for both of you.
Tengo una pregunta. Es una pregunta bastante sencilla para ambos.
But also maybe complex.
Pero también quizá un poquito compleja.
It's a question I've been asking Nicaraguans since I've been here, the people of Nicaragua.
Es una pregunta que he estado haciendo a los nicaragüenses, al pueblo de Nicaragua desde que vine.
And I've been asking them who is Daniel Ortega.
Y me les he estado preguntando quién es Daniel Ortega.
The liberal press, and including in Britain the BBC and the Guardian.
Y la prensa liberal, incluyendo la BBC y el Guardian.
Say that Daniel Ortega is a ruthless dictator, terrorizing the people of Nicaragua and committing murders of the people.
We have forgotten designer eyeglasses.
Yeah, I know.
Ellos Estos periódicos han dicho que han respondido a esa pregunta diciendo que el presidente Daniel Ortega es un dictador cruel que promueve el terrorismo en contra de los nicaragüenses.
But the people that I've spoken to paint a very different picture. They talk of our leader, our commander, a humble man of peace, known simply as Daniel.
El pueblo nicaragüense y las personas nicaragüenses con las que he logrado conversar me dicen que es un líder, es nuestro comandante, es una persona sencilla, es simplemente Daniel.
So I guess my question to both of you is, who is Daniel Ortega?
Entonces mi pregunta para ambos es simplemente, ¿no? ¿Quién es Daniel?
Point out that you have to take into account who are the correspondents of these media.
Solo quiero señalar que es muy importante tomar en cuenta quiénes son estos corresponsales.
In general, have assigned as correspondents people from the different, the other side, the small side of Nicaragua. I think you have to take that into account because it's very important. Depends on who says it. They are not transmitting the voice of the Nicaraguan people. They're speaking on their own account. So,
estos reporteros, los corresponsales, ¿no?, de estos lugares, están hablando en su propia opinión. Ellos no están transmitiendo las opiniones verdaderas del pueblo nicaragüense, de la gente de Nicaragua.
¿Quién sos
vos? Bueno, yo soy un sobreviviente.
I am a survivor.
No,
porque cuando empezamos a luchar,
because when we began the struggle,
muy jóvenes nosotros,
very young, all of us,
y empezamos a muchos de nosotros caímos presos.
Many of us were jailed.
Nos torturaron.
We were tortured.
Pasamos largos años en prisión.
We spent years in prison.
Luego fuimos liberados.
Then we were liberated.
Por acciones del Frente Sandinista.
By the actions of the Frente Sandinista.
Y continuamos en la batalla.
And we continued in the struggle.
Y nunca se nos ocurría que íbamos a vivir la victoria.
And we never imagined that we would live to see the victory.
Cuando nos veíamos los compañeros en la clandestinidad, en las ciudades o en la montaña, más bien nos preguntamos quién será el próximo.
When we would gather on the comrades in clandestinity, we would ask one another.
Estamos convencidos que nos iba a llegar el turno de morir en la lucha, morir en combate.
We would ask one another who would be the next. We were convinced that our turn to die in the struggle would eventually come.
Pero teníamos la convicción, la certeza de que se iba a alcanzar la victoria.
But we had the conviction, we were certain that we would reach victory, that we would win.
Y por eso digo, realmente todo este proceso que hemos vivido.
That's why this entire process that we have lived.
Donde finalmente alcanzamos la victoria, después enfrentar la guerra impuesta por los Estados Unidos.
Where we were able to achieve the victory, and then after that we had to deal with the aggression by the United States.
Lograr salir con fortaleza después de esa guerra y ir a hacer una oposición con la consigna de gobernar desde abajo, era ir con el pueblo a dar la batalla.
Having survived, having lived through the Contra-Revolutionary War, and then after that, to work from the opposition with the theme governing from underneath, from below.
Donde teniendo una fuerza enorme como partido, podíamos votar cualquier gobierno, eso, ante las medidas que ellos estaban tomando. No lo hicimos.
Where we had the strength, we had the power to overthrow any one of those governments, but we had decided not to do that. We didn't do that.
En algunos momentos de crisis, nos plantearon que nos daban el gobierno de nuevo. Y que ellos se retiraban. Y dijimos, no, ustedes tienen que cumplir. Y nosotros no vamos a regresar al gobierno de esa manera. Vamos a regresar por los votos.
in some of the worst moments of crisis during the liberal governments, many of the governments even proposed handing the government back to us, and we turned them down. We said we will not get back to power that way. We would get back to power only through the votes.
Y luego, bueno, la victoria en el 2006, llegamos al gobierno en 2007, y los programas sociales, el avance en la economía, todo lo que venía, pero Estados Unidos no quería ese ejemplo.
And then we finally came to power in 2006. We assumed the government in 2007, and we began to carry out the social programs. You were able to see the economic advances. But the United States didn't want that type of example.
Particularmente la gente de la Florida.
And particularly the right-wing people in Florida.
Que no entendían, están enardecidos porque el frente había retornado al gobierno después que ellos habían luchado con la contra para que Nicaragua fuese ocupada por la contra y por las tropas norteamericanas porque ese era el plan.
They couldn't understand. They were irritated that after so many years the Frente Sandinista was able to return to the government after they had fought during the Contra-Revolutionary War.
Digo, soy un sobreviviente gracias a Dios. Porque sí, siempre he tenido ese pensamiento cristiano.
I'm a survivor. I'm a survivor thanks to God, because I've always had this the Christian beliefs, the Christian values.
Esto yo lo decía cuando me entrevistaban en los años 80. Me entrevistaban periodistas norteamericanos o de otros países y me preguntaban por mi formación ideológica. Yo les decía que la esencia mía y mi inspiración era Cristo. Para mí Cristo era un ejemplo de lucha por la justicia, por los pobres. Y que fue con el paso del tiempo que conocí el pensamiento marxista, conocí la revolución de Lenin, conocí lo que es las concepciones ideológicas, pero la esencia ha estado ahí.
When people used to ask me this question in the 80s, that's what I used to always say. They used to ask me about my ideological formation, and I used to always tell them that my example has always been Christ, Jesus Christ. As a person that has struggled for justice, that has struggled for peace. Later on in my life, I learned about Leninism and Marxism and other things. But my inspiration throughout my life has always been Christ.
Luego, a lo largo de este camino, ¿cuántos atentados?
And after that, how many attempts against my life?
Atentados. Y nunca cantidad de atentados. Desde los años 80.
From the 80s, I've had attacks on my life.
Y nunca he usado carro blindado.
And I have never used an armored car.
Aquí todo el mundo piensa que yo siempre andaba un carro blindado. Nunca he usado carro blindado.
A lot of people think that I always use an armored car, but I have never used an armored car.
También cuando visito otros países, ahí sí nos ponen carro blindado.
When I visit other countries, that's when they provide me with an armored car.
Nunca he usado carro blindado.
I have never used an armored car.
Mi carro blindado es Cristo.
My armored car is...
El pueblo es el que me cuida.
My armored car is Christ. My armored car is the people of Nicaragua who care for me.
Pero yo quiero agregar que para mí el concepto de sobreviviente es muy pasivo.
I would like to add that for me the concept of a survivor is peace, is pacific, as too pacific.
I think he's a struggler and a strong leader. And when I say the word strong, I don't mean what you meant or implied in your question, trying to put together what they say, the small part of this country. No, I think he's strong because he has faith. He's strong because he's able to love. in the middle of the hardest circumstances, he has this patience, this serenity, this prudencia. I don't have it. I have to confess. I don't know how he does it. I'm not patient. I'm not able to just sit. I'm always thinking, and I'm always trying to do. Daniel is very patient, and that's a great quality and a great human value, because when you're patient, you're able to think, maybe with passion, yes, but without despair. You have to think on all the different ways to overcome whatever circumstance, whatever difficulty you're facing. And we saw that last year. We saw it. We went to that theater called National Dialogue. I don't know how he did it. He did it. Because I wanted to get up and really volcar mi corazón, put my heart out. I couldn't do it. But Daniel was looking at everyone, listening and thinking with patience. And I'm sure he was thinking at that moment all the different ways to overcome that situation, which they call crisis. I don't call crisis, because we had all our people kidnapped by 2,500 people, the whole Nicaraguan population kidnapped. And the police locked up in the headquarters. That doesn't happen anywhere. I mean, he accepted it through patience and wisdom. And I think he's a man of patience and wisdom and serenity, which are very noble qualities. I have to acknowledge.
I have just one last question before leaving. One of the major issues in our presidential campaign is the migration crisis, mostly from the...
Tengo una última pregunta antes de salir. Uno de los temas más importantes que se está tocando en esta campaña electoral en los Estados Unidos es la crisis migratoria.
It's mostly from the Northern Triangle, from these countries. We were just in Honduras, and this country is essentially a client of the United States, and most of the migrants are from there. Guatemala, El Salvador, which just hosted Mike Pompeo.
La mayor parte de esta migración ocurre en el llamado Triángulo del Norte. Acabo de venir de Honduras. Honduras es un país que es prácticamente cliente de los Estados Unidos. Igual en el caso de El Salvador, donde Mike Pompeo acaba de estar de visita.
Why is your country not contributing as much to this migration crisis? What happened here that kept people at home? Or are they going to Costa Rica instead of the United States? Why aren't we seeing so many Nicaraguans as part of these caravans?
¿Por qué Nicaragua no contribuye a este flujo, a esta crisis migratoria? ¿Qué es lo que los nicaragüenses están haciendo? ¿Por qué los nicaragüenses deciden quedarse aquí? ¿Están migrando a Costa Rica o...?
Primero, se va a Costa Rica tradicionalmente, había una tradición por razones de trabajo.
Our people have traditionally traveled to Costa Rica for work reasons.
Y hay que recordar que toda esa zona fronteriza de Costa Rica, incluyendo Liberia.
It's important to remember that that entire northern area of Costa Rica, including Liberia, used to be Nicaraguan territory.
Entonces, esa población realmente tiene raíces nicaragüenses.
So that population really has Nicaraguan roots.
Y eso hace que haya un flujo permanente, ¿no?, de nicaragüenses hacia Costa Rica y también de Costa Rica hacia Nicaragua.
And that's why you always have a permanent flowing of people from Costa Rica to Nicaragua and from Nicaragua to Costa Rica.
Pero no se da una migración, digamos, así fuerte como la que se está dando hacia los Estados Unidos de parte de población hondureña o de población salvadoreña o guatemalteca.
But this is not a very strong migratory flow like is the case of the Honduras, El Salvador, and Guatemala.
Porque es mano de obra también que necesita Costa Rica.
Because it's also labor that Costa Rica needs.
Si los nicaragüenses dejan de llegar a Costa Rica, se desploma la economía costarricense.
If Nicaraguans would stop traveling to Costa Rica, the Costa Rican economy would simply implode.
Y los que se habían ido después de abril ya han retornado.
And the ones who had left the country after April of last year have already returned.
Hayan quedado algunos como estos que quieren retomar acciones armadas, violentas.
Some of them have remained out of the country seeking to carry out military attacks.
Entonces, sí nos preocupa la situación de Guatemala, Honduras, El Salvador, en tanto que no sentimos una actitud de parte del gobierno de los Estados Unidos para invertir para que esos países tengan mejores condiciones. Y también deberían invertir en Nicaragua porque aquí lo protegemos del narcotráfico que va para los Estados Unidos.
We are very concerned about the situation in Honduras, Guatemala, and El Salvador, and we believe that the government of the United States should invest in improving the conditions in these countries. They should also invest in improving the conditions in Nicaragua because we are the barrier against drug trafficking and organized crime.
Y no que como les decía al comienzo, les acaban de quitar 40 millones de dólares para dárselo a la contrarrevolución venezolana.
And not like what they've done recently, they just withdrew $40 million from these countries in the north of Central America to give it to the contrarrevolutionary forces in Venezuela.
Y la última noticia hoy es que está molesto el gobierno norteamericano con Guatemala porque no firma ser el tercer país de tráfico seguro.
And the latest news that we read today, that we found out today, is that the government of the United States is angry at Guatemala because Guatemala hasn't signed the agreement of safe passage.
Sí, lo que lo ha promovido con México, realmente un chantaje. Porque México le han puesto una pistola en la cabeza.
The plan that Mexico has been promoting, but it's a plan that it just seeks to blackmail Guatemala at this moment.
La amenaza del impuesto a México, esa fue
the threat of applying taxes to Mexico. Okay.
Sí.
Talking about future, Daniel spoke about future on July the 19th. The future is hard work, and we have hard-working people. Nuestro futuro es trabajo. Hard-working people in the countryside, hard-working people in the cities, and that's our future, to work hard, to prosper, and to work hard to preserve peace, to promote reconciliation, which is difficult, but possible in Nicaragua. Promover reconciliación, promover family values, which means the possibility to recover.
A pesar de que tenemos la economía más frágil de la región, en este momento Nicaragua sigue siendo el país más seguro de la región. Y vienen de Guatemala, vienen de... ya pueden aquí andar sin carros blindados en Nicaragua, de verdad.
Although Nicaragua has the most fragile economy in the region, we are still the safest country. People from Guatemala, from other areas, can come to our country, and they don't need armored cars.
And I think our people have confidence in Nicaragua and in the future of Nicaragua.
El problema es la inseguridad en estos países muy grande, ¿no?
The problem is insecurity in these countries.
Buscando seguridad, aparte de trabajo, es la vida.
people are not only looking for jobs, for work, they're also looking for security for their lives.
Thank you so much.
Muchísimas gracias.